Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is a special session of the Fayette County Commissioners. The only business to be brought here tonight is the Area Planning Commission's recommendation on the request for a change to the language for windmill setback limits. Before we start, shall we stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, please?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you and welcome to the meeting. Just as a matter of housekeeping, if you have a cell phone, would you please silence it? I will begin, since the petition to the APC was brought by Mr. Snyder and his people who hired him, I think I'll let them go first. What we're going to do is allow a 10-minute opening presentation by representatives of both sides of the issue, after which anyone from the audience that wishes to speak, there's a sign-up sheet on the podium. We did have plans to have a sign-up sheet in advance outside, but the table didn't materialize, so this is the best we can do for right now. We're going to limit each person's comments to 3 minutes. At the end of the comments, I will allow 20 minutes for both sides for a closing statement, and then we'll go from there. Are there any questions? Okay. Mr. Mossberg, would you care to speak? Would you care to speak? Can everybody hear me okay? Okay, I'll speak up. My apologies.
My name is Craig Mossberg. I live on 600 North, 7219 West. Commissioners, yesterday I had a chance to review the placements of the industrial wind turbines down at the APC office. So this time I want to take the chance to thank a few people. First of all, the county council members for voting for the abatement, and for having no feeling for the Fayette County taxpayers, especially the non-participating taxpayers. Like one member said, it's all about money and being the poorest county in the state. I also am glad to see council member receive a turbine on her land. Second, I want to thank the area planning and zoning members of the discussion they failed to have at the last APC meeting, plus changing the number of turbines from 43 to 52. And last, to you, our county commissioners, thank you for giving me a chance to have 15 turbines in a substation within a mile radius of my farm now. Now we'll be able to look out in any direction and see a turbine. None of the county officials who have made this decision will have this opportunity. You will be destroying my peaceful life I have been living for the last 9 years of my retirement because of your money-hungry decisions. It's not too late to stand up to NextEra and say we want more setbacks for our taxpayers and not be threatened by with a breach of contract lawsuit. Finally, I know we're 120 acres for sale on 600 North with a great view of 52 turbines. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Is there a representative for NextEra or the group that petitioned for them to be here? You want to speak? Ms. Soliday?
Point of order. There's several of us that represent the petitioners. Are we each going to have the opportunity to speak?
Those of you that wish to speak, vote whichever side, will have 3 minutes to make your presentation as long as you sign in at the podium, please.
Do you want to alternate between those for and those against the petition? Is that what you're trying to do?
I'm just going to let people speak as they wish. Ms. Holliday, thank you.
Thank you, Commissioners, Council. Again, my name is Mary Soliday. I'm an attorney from Indianapolis. I represent NextEra Energy. I intend to be very brief this evening, Commissioners. As I think Mossberg indicated, we have filed our petition for approval by the BZA, which is a special exception under your current ordinance. We have filed for that, made that application. I believe Mr. McDaniel accepted it on June 15th or so. We are looking forward to a public hearing on August the 6th. As you are well aware, a special exception under Indiana law is a discretionary approval, and the burden of proof is on the applicant, that is NextEra, to demonstrate to you that the findings of fact set out in your ordinance are met by evidence. And as I indicated to the Plan Commission on May 28th, we intend to submit substantial evidence at that hearing so that we can, in our view, adequately, under Indiana law, establish the findings of fact. So, not to get overly technical here, but I'm essentially indicating that we look forward to that hearing. You can imagine what we think, and the Plan Commission heard me say this in May, we think your ordinance is a very good ordinance. And why do I say that? Because I've seen ordinances all over the state of Indiana. I've been involved in the wind industry for about 7 years, and I can tell you, I think it's a fair ordinance. Is it perfect? Maybe not, but it's a very good ordinance. I'm not sure there is a perfect ordinance, but I say that because, as you can imagine, a good ordinance is an ordinance that's fair to all, right? And your process, which is a special exception, is a discretionary approval. It is not, as in some counties, and I think we'll use Wells County here for an example, it's not what I call a check the box, where if you submit this, this, and this, and do this and this, board has to approve. That is not what your process is, as you are well aware in Fayette County. There was a lot of thought given to your ordinance, and it is a discretionary approval based on evidence submitted. So again, we look forward to presenting that evidence in August. We also think what's interesting about your ordinance, and no other ordinance that I'm aware of, by the way, in the state of Indiana, has a dual process where first the Area Plan Commission takes testimony, and then later that evening the Board of Zoning Appeals makes the final decision. What is unique, and I think a good thing about that process, is it brings in more input, right? Because the Area Plan Commission hears evidence, makes a recommendation to the BZA, it allows more voices, it allows more input, and that is a very good thing. So, I compliment you on your ordinance. I know, again, a lot of thought went into it. And of course, before this hearing on August the 6th, there will be public notice, not only in the newspaper, but to adjoining property owners, and there will be many people who will receive individual notice of that hearing.
She has 10.
She has 10 minutes for opening speech.
Okay, now I'm trying to wind up.
Take your time.
Thank you. So I was indicating that there will be public notice of that hearing. So I guess one of the things I mentioned at the Plan Commission meeting that I think is another good thing. Very recently, there was a Court of Appeals decision in Indiana, and it was about a wind farm in Wells County, Indiana, which again has this check-the-box sort of ordinance. What's interesting about that is that it upholds, at least in my reading of the case, the authority of the Plan Commission to regulate land use in the county, meaning we're a home rule state. And again, that's a good thing. Each county determines its own rules. Indiana courts have affirmed that in a number of contexts, in a number of cases, but essentially, it is up to you commissioners to set the rules. And I applaud your plan commission for being very thoughtful when it brought this ordinance to you several years ago, and applaud you for your thoughtfulness in adopting it. So certainly, it is in your purview, and no one's going to take that power away from you. And I think that, again, that leads to the conclusion that this is a good process that's set out. Now, let me talk just for a second about setbacks. As you are well aware, by contract, NextEra has agreed to a, 1,500-foot setback. 1400. Maybe it's 14. Is that 14? Thank you. I couldn't remember if it was 14 or 15. Okay. 1,400-foot setback. I believe, Mr. McDaniel, your setback is 1,000? Okay. So your ordinance provides for 1,000-foot setback. So essentially, we have agreed to enhance that by 40%. So we intend to honor that commitment. The site plan that we've submitted will, in all respects, honor that. And just to avoid any confusion on this point, we have submitted an application that provides for up to 52 turbines. Will there be 52 turbines? Maybe not. Maybe there will only be 49 turbines, but there will be not more than 52. You're going to say, well, why don't you know? Well, the reason we don't know today is a great deal of engineering has to go into establishment of the very precise turbine locations. And in the industry, that is called micro-siting. That micro-siting is very expensive to conduct. We, as any wind company that I've dealt with, would of course prefer is to know that it has or has not received its zoning approval, and then it would conduct the micro-siting, and then it would seek an improvement location permit from the building director, and then at that time the precise locations would be established. And again, I'm just here to reiterate that that 1,400 foot setback will be honored regardless of the precise location, but again, not to exceed 52 turbines. You heard a lot of, commissioners, but you may well have been in attendance. The Plan Commission heard a lot of testimony on May 28th, and as you sure have heard, they have they voted to essentially support their current ordinance and not recommend changes to you. We talked a lot that evening about things such as sound levels and wildlife and property values, construction period, which is about 9 months, by the way. All of these things will, again, be addressed at length. And we, as you probably are also aware, we have established ground rules for that hearing in terms of time that each party can speak, how the process is going to work that evening, how submittals will be made in advance so that the Plan Commission and the BZA will have adequate time to review submittals. We have worked that out, and I believe both bodies have approved that process. So again, we look forward to providing that information. We look forward to abiding in all respects with your current ordinance, and again, believe your ordinance is a good one. So I'm happy to answer any questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Sullivan. Just as a matter of information, I want to explain that Mrs. King is not here tonight. Her brother-in-law in Minnesota passed away, so she is there attending the funeral services. Do we have the auditorium from 5 o'clock, which was just an hour for prep, until 9 o'clock? So we will not go past 9 o'clock. That gives us 2 hours and about 49 minutes. And I know not everyone here will want to speak, but I guess we'll start in the first row. If anyone wants to speak, please approach the podium and sign in. And as soon as you start speaking, you will have 3 minutes from that time.
I respectively ask for the same amount of time that NextEra Council received for an opening statement.
That's denied because the same amount of time was offered to your representative.
And who would that be?
Mr. Mossberg.
Mr. Mossberg.
He does not represent me. Mr. Snyder represents me.
You have 3 minutes, Mr. Spencer.
I would like my objection to that to be noted.
This meeting is being recorded, so it's noted.
Okay. If the ordinance is such a good ordinance, I would like to know why the power company has unilaterally decided to extend by 40% the setbacks that are called in the ordinance.
That Mr. Spencer, you might pull the microphone a little closer.
That would indicate that there's a problem with the ordinance. The next thing is, I believe this has come down to a money situation for the county, and you're failing to protect each of us citizens in the county, despite the fact that there's been, at the previous meetings, an overwhelming majority of people that have attended those meetings in opposition to this wind project. And I think that needs to be taken into consideration. NextEra would have you believe that this is well thought out, well regulated, and that they have been burdened with all types of regulations, and that's not the case. That's why this division of NextEra is called their unregulated division. Keep that in mind, please, because It's not, as one commissioner said at one point, a handful of people in opposition. It's actually just the opposite. It's a very small handful of county citizens who are proponents of this wind project. There's a vast majority of us that are opposed to it. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Second row. Judge? Okay, let's go behind you, Craig. Folks, you want to speak? When you sign your name in, before you start speaking, would you give us your name first, please? Thank you.
My name is Sharon Mullen, and I actually live in Henry County, but they're having proposed eight turbines put in Henry County that goes along with the Whitewater Farm. And I wasn't notified of this even happening until a few friends from Fayette County came and told me about it. So I rushed up to the Planning Commission at Newcastle, and I asked them, and I got the maps and the sites, and started asking around, telling people, and they had not even known about it. And it just didn't seem fair. So, I mean, 2 days ago, I received a letter of a special meeting, Planning Commission meeting, for last night, and it was at the Smith Auditorium, or Smith Building at Newcastle. And it was a special meeting, and none of my neighbors received a notice in the mail about the special meeting. Some of us don't get the paper, and we're property owners. And so I made 40 copies of this letter I got, and I traveled around Saturday to all the homeowners in my neighborhood that these huge 600 turbines was going to be. And I passed them out to let them know about this meeting so somebody could be up there to be able to talk about it, because I mean, we're property owners. Our homes are our investments. We put everything in it. And it just wasn't right. Anyway, while I was walking around or driving around, I found people right on US 40 that does not even know that these 600-foot turbines were going to be right behind their homes or across the road. And I'm like, don't we deserve to know? I mean, don't we need a notice for this to be prepared? Because I remember the last meeting, Mr. Ritberger standing up and saying, you know, let's not move this back a half a mile. It'll kill the project. Well, they've been working on it since 2007. I mean, why don't us property owners know that? We've paid taxes. I mean, we could be working on this project since 2007. I mean, I've been retired for a year and a half, and I look forward to seeing the sunsets. I spend all my week out in my garden, my yard, and now when I look out the window and look west at a sunset, I'm just gonna see, it's like a patch of thistles. And it's just not right. It just seems not fair that these friends can't come up and tell us that this is happening so we can be prepared. I mean, these turbines are industrial power plants. They're not silos, they're not barns, they're not hog buildings, they're not cattle dairy farms. They're dangerous. They can explode. They can catch on fire.
I'm sorry, ma'am. Your time is up.
So we need more than that setback.
Thank you. Anyone else in that row coming this way? Yes.
Hey, guys.
Hello.
My name is Audrey McGuire. I'm actually a resident of the city. I live in Connersville. I run the grassroots Revive the Ville, and I know that I won't be seeing them, but I will say that I work with people all the time that just wish their kids could come home to Connersville and have a job. I know that the wind turbines won't bring those jobs to Connersville, but this could be a step in the direction that will make Connersville more opening and inviting to other jobs that can bring things to Connersville. It would make us look much more progressive. And as a young person of Connersville, I want to live here, and I want to raise my family here, and I want kids to come back and have jobs here. So thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Same row? Okay, we'll go the row behind Ms. Soliday. Anyone from that row there? Go this way. Mr. Caldwell? Sorry. You stood up just a second too late. We'll get you in just a moment.
Do you want to alternate that?
No, I'll just go back right that way.
That's fair, I think.
Hi, my name is Dave Caldwell. I live at 8500 North, County Road 450 West. My wife and I both live there. We're in the area that's going to be utilized for the turbines, assuming this goes through. When this first came up, my wife and I were both very concerned about it. We had heard a lot of things about wind turbines and so forth, and we felt like the best thing to do would be to find out and talk to people that live in an area where they exist. So my wife, Marty, and I went to Benton County, where the turbines have been in place for longer, I think the longest time in Indiana. And after standing on the porch of people who are living out in the country near the turbines and talking to them, talking to people in town, talking to realtors, talking to people all over that county, we came back convinced that even though I'd rather not have to look at them either, frankly, the benefits outweigh the deficits. Regulations, as I understand them, for Benton County are very similar to those that we have here. And the people in Benton County that we talked to were very happy with the end result of what's happened to their county because of the turbines. So I urge you to go ahead and approve this. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am?
Hi, my name is Anna Arnold. My husband and I, we live at 300 North, Falmouth, Indiana.
Pull the microphone down.
Sorry about that.
It's all right.
We own land, and we're lifelong residents of Fayette County. When this all started up, we too went around and visited several wind farms, talked to people, and everything that we heard was very positive. We did some tours, we talked with people at Benton County, you know, we went around and did our homework on everything. We are very much in favor of this wind project, and I just want to say that we're in favor of it and hope that you will keep the setbacks where they are, and thank you for your time.
Thank you, ma'am. Continuing the same row over, then get my bearings here. Larry? Mr. Keller?
My name is Larry Keller. My wife and I have received the God-given gift of caring for and making payments on farmland in Fairview Township, Fayette County. We have signed a contract to be a part of the wind project. We are not in favor of any changes to the WECS ordinance in any way. We have been working on this project since 2007. There was a land ordinance association formed in 2007, and we did as a group go through an extensive research agenda aimed at learning the good, the bad, and the ugly about the present wind energy installations. We all wanted to make the right decisions. So after countless hours of making contact with people who had older wind farms, as in Wyoming, to a bit newer wind farm in states like Nebraska, North Dakota, to Illinois, and finally to the more modern wind farm in Benton County here in Indiana. As we compiled information from landowners in each of the states that we talked to, we began to build our wind farm on paper. One of our greatest points of interest was to have a strong wind ordinance that would become our open for business sign. This would become our rule book to attract a first-class, top-notch, American-based developer. We didn't want our tax dollars or the profits from our homegrown American wind to go to a foreign country. We wanted to create an ordinance that the members of any governmental body in Fayette County could read, cast a vote in favor of, knowing in their hearts that their vote of approval was in the best interest of the majority of the population of our county. After a lot of hard work, this was accomplished long before any developer was interviewed. There was not one single developer that had any input into our wind ordinance. We cannot put out a sign that says we want a wind farm and here are the rules, and after millions of dollars have been invested by the developer, suddenly change the rules. That won't fly in any business deal, and it certainly won't fly in this case. Benton County, White County, Randolph County, Fayette County, Henry County, Rush County, and even Tipton County has 69 windmills using 1,000-foot setback.
20 seconds, sir.
Pardon me?
20 seconds.
Wisdom is a gift of the Holy Spirit. Wisdom is doing now what we know we will be happy with in the future. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Continuing the same row. Folks over here. Okay. We'll continue on across to the row behind Mr. Keller. Second row behind him. Mr. Clark or any of you?
Good evening. My name is John Clark, and me and my wife live in Bentonville. I'd like to first publicly offer all of ours present here tonight, Ms. King's, some condolences on the passing of her family. Her presence here is surely missed tonight. I have trouble with three-minute speeches, so I wrote a two-minute one tonight. But I'd first like to make a statement that I wanted to make at the APC, but I ran out of my three-minute time. And this is to the audience. I'd like to read this. I, as many here, do have friends and neighbors on both sides of this project. I want to let mine know that regardless of the final end result of this project, I will still be your friend and neighbor. I will still stop to help you if you need assistance, and I hope you will do the same. I want us to continue to wear a common shirt, the shirt of friendship. The ordinance that's in question tonight was passed in 2008 after due diligence from the APC at looking at other setback ordinances. On March 26, 2015, the headlines of the News Examiner front page read, "Area Counties Consistent with Wind Turbine Setbacks," and concluded or summarized in that our ordinance is not out of the ordinary or different. At the APC meeting on May 23rd, Mr. Harrell, after public input motion to give the petition before you tonight an unfavorable recommendation. Mr. Hill was served on the APC when the ordinance was created and stated the current ordinance was a good one. Mr. Gabe Nobby seconded the motion based on his own research into the other county ordinances and stated he believed our current one was a sound one. The motion passed unanimously. Gentlemen of the commissioners, due to these 4 points, I too believe this ordinance is a sound one. Therefore, I urge you to make a strong and unanimous decision to accept the unfavorable recommendation of the APC and deny this petition before you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Continuing on that same row, anybody over here wish to speak? I'm starting to run out of rows. They're starting to kind of get mixed up here. So about 8 rows back. Anyone on this side? Ma'am, I see you looking.
My name is Teresa Glover. I have questions. If this was started in 2007, I went to that first meeting. I asked for information, was given nothing. If this is a wonderful project, how come it's not on a website like Apex? They seem to be seen, we can see it. I've went to the other meetings in other counties. It seems like everybody is very open. I've listened to their experts. There's several websites that are against. Why is that? There seems to be, issues. Why can't we compromise on this 1,400 feet? Maybe 2640 is too much. Why can't we compromise? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
My name's Tracy Nobby, and I live on 800 North, probably the highest point in Posey Township. I have lived there over 27 years. I have never received anything in the mail about turbines coming, no neighbors speaking or coming knocking on doors. I don't think you have proven enough about the wind turbines, whether how it affects livestock, wildlife, even the human beings. These things spin, they flash. Do you know how that affects people with vertigo? I don't think you have given me enough concrete evidence to support that this is a good thing. I'm all for green energy. I have been thinking about solar panels on my house and coming up with new ways to use natural resources. As what I have read with the setback, it also states from the residence, and it should be the property line. I should be able to do whatever I want within legal reasons on my property without having some sort of repercussions from the wind turbine companies. And I think instead of jumping so quickly, if you're so dead set on this, of passing this through, then you do need to make compromises. Like Teresa said, 2,600 and some may be too much. But it also needs to be from the property line and not from the residence. I think that, you know, we're so desperate in Fayette County to get income coming in here and making it like it used to be, that I don't want you jumping too soon. Because when things are done, it's a 30-year plan. You can't go back and take it away. And there's always the golden rule: do unto others as you would have them do unto you.
Thank you. Okay, I'm going to go back here, the row behind Mr. Clark. Anyone back there on this side? Anyone in the row behind? Okay, anyone else over here on this side? Yes, ma'am.
Good evening. My name is Darla Lane, and I live in Posey Township. I'd like to say I'm a proud landowner. With my husband, I've only been there for 2 years. I've been a Fayette County resident for 2 years, but my husband has been a lifelong Fayette County resident. I say I'm a proud landowner if it's only been for 2 years, because I live on a beautiful property where I can see beautiful sunsets and enjoy nature. It's one of the main reasons why I left my residence in Wayne County when I got married. What I ask is that you understand that I am not against green energy, and I understand that that it may be asking too much to say that it's not, I don't feel that it's not even a proper place for a wind farm in Fayette County. I do agree that a compromise would create respect for non-participating landowners with reasonable and safe setbacks. I'd also like to state that I believe that it's naive to think that a wind farm is the salvation of Fayette County. I do believe that Fayette County needs to reinvent itself. I believe that Fayette County has experienced a lot of very sad situations in the past history. But I have been, prior to Fayette County, a resident of Wayne County for a very long time, and I see Wayne County reinventing itself in very healthy, very unifying, and very exciting ways. And I challenge you all to think of this type of reinvention instead of thinking that there's salvation in one way. I guess most of all, I would like to say that I agree with a lot of my friends in thinking that it would be respectful for more reasonable setbacks to create more safety for all, both people, and like they said, people and wildlife. I guess I want to make sure that we all understand what we're deciding when that decision is made. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Anyone else on this side? Yes, sir.
Hello there. Thanks for giving us time to speak. My name is Stu Linville, and I'm from Rush County. And the reason I'm here is because what goes on here is also going to affect us. And so I feel it's just as important for us to be involved as well. Just wanted to bring up a couple points. It was brought up that folks have been to Benton County to explore their area and what they've been doing for the last several years. It's important to point out that the Benton County versus Fayette and Rush County, are to compare those two, is not the greatest in the world. Benton County has like 8,000 people. Most of those people live within the city limits. So the rural areas have very few people compared to our area in Rush County and Fayette. So you're not going to find as many people out in those areas who are going to be as affected as people in Fayette, Rush, and Henry. It was also, and also their towers are 326 feet versus the potential 500 plus feet up to 600. In Benton County, they are in rows, linear rows, and so it's more of an organized look. The proposed areas here, as well in the other counties around here, are going to be a scattered pattern, totally different look, totally different feel, and there's going to be a lot more people living out in those counties who are not participating members. The other thing, it was talked about, you know, these will hopefully bring people into the county. I don't know how that could be. I don't know how many people, if you were looking to move into Fayette County, Henry, or Rush, and you don't want to live in a city, who is going to want to really move out into an area where there's tons of farm or where there's tons of windmills or turbines? Who is going to want to do that? The other issue is, once wind companies get in, others are going to be starting to move in. We're experiencing that over in Rush County. We've got other companies that are coming in looking at other parts. So if you get more wind companies coming in, you're going to get more area in the county that's going to be filled with these. You're going to get less people that's going to want to move in. You're going to get less kids who are going to want to stay and build houses out in those areas to participate in the future growth of the county. So I don't really see how it's really going to benefit long-term any of these counties that participate in this. Long-term, it's going to hurt more than it's going to help. The other thing, too, is asbestos and cigarettes. Years ago, nobody ever thought that they were bad for you. Asbestos was used. Cigarettes have been used. They're still used. But we've now found out that they're bad for you. Asbestos has been banned, and more people are moving away from cigarettes. My point there is that there's not been enough really deep research for the health and not only the effects of the community. Is that it?
Yes. Right now it is, yes.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Anyone else on this side? Yes, sir.
My name is Cecil Bell. I'd like to thank you guys for letting me speak. First, I'd like to thank the people in the WPCC for all their support that we've had. To my understanding, in the last couple of days, I found out this was pretty much a done deal that nobody even knew about. Second, I'd like to thank the people in the green shirts. Hopefully, what they're trying to bring to this county makes sense at some point. But what they've done to the families and to their neighbors in Posey and Fairview Township will never, ever be repaired. So I'm hoping that you guys are listening to what we're saying and make a good decision on what we're going to do for our county from here on out. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Anyone else from this side?
Hello, my name is Betty Bell.
Would you sign in, please? Thank you.
And I'm totally unprepared for a speech.
It's quite all right.
But my heart is hurting for my children. My son Cecil purchased a home and his wife Diana to raise their three boys. and it's beautiful, and they've worked on it and rebuilt and redone and fixed all kinds of beautiful things in their yards and everything. And I was just there the other day looking how beautiful the scenery is. But he doesn't even know, and nobody knows that I know of, that knows where they're going to put those windmills. They're not telling where. So I've heard many people are already putting their homes up for sale, and they'll have to divulge that those are going to be there. And I would never buy a house there. I live in an area similar to him in the middle of the Johnson Farms. We've lived on our 1 acre for 54 years. And I look out and I have the beautiful sunsets and the beauty all around me when they plant the corn, and they no longer have animals there that I had to contend with, the flies and everything. And all these years I've had to contend with the spreading of manure, hog manure, cow manure, and couldn't hang clothes on the line because the towels and stuff would smell like that. My thing today is very personal. I don't even know if you want to hear what I have to say, but I feel compelled to say it. If they put one mill in front of my house, beside my house, or behind it, my husband and I will leave our home. Even if we can't sell it, it will just sit there. It owes us nothing. We've lived there 54 years. But it's our home until we no longer can take care of it, and we'll have to move. I think that we've been very conservative with water, and I have from the day I was born. We were conservative because we didn't want a high water bill, and back then, you know, it didn't even cost much, but we didn't have money either. But the one thing about it is that today, what I see is towns like Modoc and everything being just buried and abandoned. There's no stores, there's nothing there, no small businesses. But one of the things that I see is we're desperate for green, but the green we're after are greenbacks. That's what they want. And I couldn't care less for that. I've lived my life out there on that farm, around all those things.
I'm sorry, ma'am, your time's up.
But I wish you good luck in your decisions that you make.
Thank you. Okay, anyone else from this side? Anyone else from the middle here? Anyone else from this side? If anyone else wants to speak, now is your time, or we're going to close this session, this part of the meeting. Okay, this portion of the meeting is closed. Mr. Mossberg, do you wish to make a closing statement or anything of that nature? You have 20 minutes to do so if you do. Okay. Ms. Salve?
I'll take that.
I'm sorry?
I'll take the 20 minutes.
Okay.
And I won't take the whole 20 minutes, so don't get too concerned.
Let me get the timer set here.
If I can find it. No. Hang on. Gosh dang it. It won't let me work.
Okay,
David,
go ahead.
It's all right.
This process has not been as transparent as some have publicly stated, and I'm not going to go into all those details. We're all used to the local workings of local government here, and we know that we have a lot of improvement to do in local government transparency. I believe that This area is currently zoned agricultural. That's what I invested a sizable amount of money. My largest lifelong investment, my wife and I, was to live in that environment. We have not asked for any exceptions when we built our house. We made sure we had the proper amount of land to live in an agricultural area. We made sure that our septic system that was installed was in compliance with local regulations. And we expect our neighbors to do the same. And they are pursuing a course of action without regard to the majority of the citizens in Posey and Fairview townships. And the zoning that's in place, I think, is fair and appropriate for a county like Fayette. There's no reason to allow exceptions to that. When I invested hundreds of thousands of dollars in my property, my biggest lifelong investment, it was not to live in the middle of an industrial complex. It was to live in an agricultural area. And I signed up for the traffic, the farm equipment, the odors, all the things that go into living in an agricultural area. I did not sign up for living in the middle of an industrial complex. And I think this will have undoubtedly a negative impact on our property values. And I don't believe the county has done due diligence in examining how this is truly going to affect the tax base for the county. Because as several have said, they may move out of the county. I know my wife and I have started making plans to do that. Not only are there property taxes involved, there's income taxes. And again, a majority of the people in Posey and Fairview townships are opposed to this project. You've seen that because the meetings had to be moved into a larger venue because of all of us that are opposed to this project as it's currently slated. And I think you have to separate what you feel is could be an economic boost for the county versus your responsibility to protect the citizens. And that is not happening here. Thank you.
Thank you. Ms. Soliday or whoever?
Thank you. I'll be very brief. Just because I'd like to just correct a couple things here tonight from what I heard in terms of the public input. And I'm sorry, I did not catch her last name, but the gal from Henry County. She was, by the way, at the Henry County meeting last night for the Area Plan Commission. The Henry County segment of this project was approved there by the Area Plan Commission by a vote to 7-0. And the reason I mention that is that I think last night was a very good precursor to the type of evidence, plus more, that the APC and BZA will hear on August the 6th. We spoke at length regarding safety, not only of the industry, but the particular safety record of NextEra Energy. We spoke a bit about wildlife. We spoke about other benefits, we spoke about benefits to the community. And we also spoke about the fact that no structure would be higher than, I believe it's 490 feet. It certainly isn't more than 500 feet. I think the statement was made as 600. That's not the way I heard it last night. Commissioners, I don't think that there really is a disagreement about this once people think about it. When you look at states like Indiana, we're not like Texas and North Dakota that have incredible wide open spaces where you can drive for miles and miles and not see anybody or anything. A setback of 2650 in a state like ours would essentially kill any wind project, whether it's NextEra or anybody else's. And I've represented other wind companies and they've all said the same thing. So I think we have to be cognizant of the fact that that standard is in fact meaning that there would not be a project that would be commercially feasible. Again, our proposal is 40% above the standard, and not just the standard of Fayette County, but of a number of other Indiana counties. Also have to point out, as you've heard this evening from folks that have investigated Benton and White County in particular, the experience there 7 years later is that the roads are better than they were, not just repair, they're actually better. The schools are better, the taxes are stabilized at lower rates, particularly in Benton County. Because of the influx of significant investment and taxation, even with the tax abatement that's now burning off, I mean, you're in year, what, six, seven now? So 70% or more of the of taxes are being captured of the project, 3 years off from 100%. So this has resulted in a very good thing for those two counties. We NextEra have seen all over the country that when wind energy investments are made in communities, other industries sometimes do locate. It's not an absolute promise, but there is a correlation between this significant investment and other industries coming to a county, other jobs and other investment. And I think this is something that your economic development people have looked at and essentially why they have supported this project. And I guess I would have to disagree. We think that Fayette County has been welcoming to us to date, and we've appreciated that. In closing, what I find really interesting about the renewable industry is that the younger generation does embrace it, whether it's Fayette County, White County, wherever you go around the state. The younger generation isn't particularly troubled by wind turbines or solar panels. Now, I'm speaking generally, but I say that because I'm not discouraged as somebody that supports renewables that the younger generation will be scared off. I think just the opposite. And what NextEra would like, of course, is an opportunity to demonstrate to all generations that it, in fact, will be a positive community member. And we, of course, want to be part of what are some very substantial efforts that, from what I've read and seen, are all good for Fayette County to reinvent itself, as was mentioned. So again, we look forward to being a community partner, and we look forward to an opportunity on August 6th to present our case as filed under the standards of your current ordinance. So happy to answer any questions, and thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, that will close the comments from the public right now. From the public, and we'll go on to the next session. The county commissioners last year, two of us and one commissioner-elect and our area plan director went to White County. We planned on a three-hour trip, got there an hour or so early, and stopped in unannounced at the assessor's office for White County. We told them, we introduced ourselves, asked them about property values, had the windmill farms affected their property values, and the lady's answer was no. Mrs. King had called prior to that some within a couple weeks or so, had called Benton County assessor, asked the same question, got the same answer. The answer was no. And I don't remember who it was, but someone brought up the fact about what our contract said. Our contract was given to the opposition folks and their attorney well before the APC hearing. And yes, when the contract that we signed does say that we are bound to, once as of the date that we signed the contract, we are bound to support the APC limits, which were in effect at that time. I don't minimize, personally, professionally, or any other way, your objections. I understand that's not comfort. I understand you probably don't have a warm, fuzzy feeling about that, but it's the truth, whether you believe it or not. Before we went to White County, if you look at this folder here, part of these binders are our contract. The others are the emails that were forwarded to all of the commissioners. I printed them out, and I've read them all that are here, except for a few that are on top. And I still have some on my computer that I have not yet read. Before I went to White County, I asked myself, if I woke up tomorrow morning and there was a windmill across from me, and I do live in the southern part of the county, I live in the same area of scenery that all of you do up in Posey, in Fairview. And I asked myself, the question should be, how would I feel if there was one across from me? But I withheld judgment until we went to White County. I've looked at the videos on Flickr effect. I've read the emails as far as the studies of subaudible noise and the medical problems that they're alleged to cause. And as a commissioner, as an elected official, not a politician, but as an elected official, I have to look at things in balance. So when I came back from White County, I answered myself, and the question I asked myself was, would I object to one across from me, road from me? And when I got up the next morning, the answer was no, I would not object to that. There is also the money. There's no hiding that, and there's no shame in that. This county, when Visjan left, the county lost 18% of their budget. That's 18% of the county's budget that we can't serve the people with. And for me to turn down the taxable income that goes to all of the taxpayers in Fayette County, Jennings and Orange and Columbia and Jackson, et cetera. Again, it's a balancing act. So I know that there are many here tonight that will leave angry. And one of the reasons for this public hearing, it is for everybody to have a fair chance to have their say. I can't do anything other than be fair, but I have to make a decision. Having said that, I will vote when we get to that part of it. Commissioner Bedore, do you have anything you want to say?
Yes. The gentleman from Rush County, when you made your mention earlier about you cannot compare Benton County to Fayette County, you're exactly right. You can't. I was in Benton County on Monday. Spent a better part of the day in Benton County looking at the windmills. The windmills, I did not see them in a row. They were scattered one side. There was a bunch skipped over, and then there was some way off in the distance. I took some recordings and looked at certain things. When this project was started, and some of you said 2007, it hasn't been in our lap for that. I didn't know about it in 2007. So basically what happens is, you know, they come to us and say, hey, we want you to look at this, and we have to make a decision. So it's not like they locked us in a room and said, believe everything we say, don't do any homework. We did. Each one of us has gone out individually and done our own study. I'm going to have to see them. I'm going to have to look at them. I did a lot of things on the internet and looked at that, and you can't believe everything you read there as well. And the lady that says this, do not make this, try to make this our salvation. It is not our salvation. When I went to Benton County and asked the commissioner, and the council member right up front. He said, this is not a one-fix-all, cure-all. It's not. He said, it's been great for Benton County. He said, but you have your own decisions to make. The residents there are scattered out more than they are here. They are closer. My biggest thing was the safety. Was it going to hurt anybody? And when any time man gets involved, there are no guarantees. But with that said, Benton County had two deaths with the windmill project that they had, and that was two workers that fell. No one since they've put them up has ever been injured, hurt, and they've done studies, impact studies on the wildlife after the fact. And I understand what you're saying, what the gentleman who said the long term of, from Rush County said the long term of it. You know, cigarettes were bad and so on and so forth. These windmills have been in California for almost 30 years. And I hate to say it, but California doesn't let anything in its state that's horrible. And if it was extremely bad, we would have already heard about it by now. The other part of that is that what hurts me the most is that people are saying that people are divided and families are not talking to each other and they're drawing a line in the sand. That's bad in a lot of ways because one issue should not destroy family members or citizens. We can disagree or agree, vice versa, back and forth. But to hate each other over a common issue says a lot about us. Every person I've ran into since we've been here, and I know this is not the issue, but I'm going to bring it up, has said we should have built the prison here when we had time, when we did it. We didn't do it. They said we kind of put our foot in the wrong order. And here we are again with another opportunity to do something good. And I don't want to see anyone move. I don't want to see anybody leave. But that's your decision. You're a homeowner. You have to make that decision. You know, there's certain things that, you know, when the one lady that came from Henry County, when they said they were building a chicken manure plant on Fayette County line, people went crazy. Guess what? It's up. I haven't heard one word. Nothing. It's there, and people were up in arms over it. There were people that don't talk to each other over the issue because they hate each other because it was back and forth. In a sense, whether you're for it or against it, whether it passes or doesn't pass, or whether the setbacks are more or less, give yourself time to not ruin a relationship or pack your bags and head for the airport. That's all I'm asking, one way or the other. And if you still don't like it, then I understand if you feel you need to leave, whether against or for. Thanks for your time. Thanks for everyone being here, for and against. You're all citizens, and we are supposed to represent you on both sides. And I feel heartfelt for the people who just absolutely don't want them because, you know, they don't like the looks of them. I can understand that. Nothing about how they look? Okay. All right. Hang on just a second. Okay, the attorney has just explained to me that there are still two more hearings after this. This is not a done deal. This is not settled. It's not finished here today. So we're going to vote however we think, either one of us, and then we'll move on, and I wish all of you the best of luck.
For the record, this is a special meeting. Simply to accept or reject the Area Plan Commission's recommendation, which says the Area Plan Commission staff recommends that the Area Plan Commission forward an unfavorable recommendation for the foregoing reasons described in the APC's findings. The wind energy conversion systems rules were adopted with the intent to provide an opportunity to allow Fayette County a role providing clean alternative energy as Fayette County land use and development policy. Should these amendments not run afoul of Indiana statutory and case law concerning vesting rights, adopting these proposed amendments would eliminate the feasibility of commercial wind energy in Fayette County. For all the foregoing reasons, the Fayette County Area Plan Commission on Thursday, May 28, 2015, forwarded an unfavorable recommendation on the petition to amend the wind energy conversion rules to the Board of Commissioners. What we have to do tonight is accept or reject that recommendation. It's a little confusing, okay? So the petition was to extend the setback rules in the ordinance from 1,000 to 2,640 feet. Am I correct, Mr. McDaniel? Okay. The APC did not find a favorable recommendation. In other words, they were against it. So now it's up to the commissioners to decide whether to accept that recommendation or reject it.
I wanted to say something real quick. The one lady got up and walked out of the room. I understand that just because you don't like the looks of them, that's not why some of you are objecting to it. I understand that. I didn't want you to think that that's what I think your issue is. There's a lot of issues why you don't want them. So continue.
Having said that, I will accept a motion to on the APC's recommendation for an unfavorable recommendation.
I will make a motion for the APC's unfavorable recommendation to keep the setbacks as they are.
And I will second that. Is there a question? All those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Two ayes. The APC's recommendation stands. Having said that, I'll accept a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second it. Question? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
This meeting is adjourned.